guys, welcome back. Today is at least the start of corn harvest day, and are you excited?
Oh, we are pumped. You're ready to rock and roll. Chuck and Dad's got the combine rolling back there already. Gonna pick a load and see what the moisture looks like in it and go from there.
Okay.
Giddy up.
So they just finished the first round on this side. When you come across this path back here by the fence, they didn't plant the outside four rows on this side so that we could get from field to field easily without taking a bunch of plants out. But when we just got back here, there is a bunch of corn on the ground that should not be there. So Levi was running up there to try to get his attention so they can stop, make some adjustments, and try to fix it. But this pregnant lady was not running up there to film it. So this is what we don't want. For some reason, it's shooting ears straight through to the back without shelling them. So we do not want that. There's another one. But it's kind of inconsistent, right?
Well, what we're trying to do is get the combine set to where we need it. This is our first time running this combine, so we're going off of what the book says, but it doesn't seem to be working out right now. So what we're looking for is to see what's happening here. The concaves, which is what's taking the kernels off of the cob, wasn't set tight enough. We were getting a bunch of corn on the ground too. So a couple different things going on. Fan speed probably an issue. We're just making some fine-tune adjustments.
This looks a lot better now. I think they've got it dialed in pretty good. I don't see hardly any corn on the ground. Okay, so what's going on is this is the wagon that they had set up to the auger to unload, and to the tractor to unload from the actual combine into the bin. But the door on this wagon doesn't fit the auger very well, so it was spilling all over the ground. So they're going to switch to this wagon and use it on the tractor, but it was full of corn from last year that's to be sacked up as deer corn, so they had to empty it into this wagon so that now it can be used to empty the combine. It's always a process. So a little background, there is about 8 acres in this field that they're working on and have started, and then we have 3 acres at Rocky Knob to do. So there isn't a whole lot of corn to be shelled. We don't sell any corn typically. We usually just put it in the bin and feed it throughout the year to cattle, sheep, goats. And then close to the following year, when we're getting close to harvest, we start stacking stuff up and selling it as deer corn. So, yeah, that's where what most of this corn will be used for. I can honestly say I don't think I have ever had to think about the heat on November 8th because it's almost 80 degrees today in Ohio and Charlie is in a t-shirt and shorts and I had to pull the sunscreen out. So I think that's a first. They are unloading the last load for the night and they are almost done with the cornfield here behind the farm and Dave's house and stuff. So they'll have the next couple evenings to finish up this little bit and then 3 acres at Rocky Knob and it probably won't take long. Luckily we've got good weather holding out for the next few days until Wednesday, I think. So Charlie and I missed the end of corn harvest. He was napping, but they finished up at Dave's and here at Rocky Knob. At Rocky Knob, there really wasn't a lot back here. It didn't do very well, and I don't know whether that was because of fungus or because it's that much closer to the deer in the woods or what the deal was. But they got it done. It'll be enough to feed sheep probably, and that's fine because that's all we need it for. But then last night, Levi went ahead and mowed all the corn stalks down. And we are going to go ahead and turn sheep in here in the next couple days so that they can clean up all the stuff on the ground, eat some of the stalks, and we'll save a little bit more hay that way. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll keep you updated on what else is going on and keep putting videos out. See ya!